start. That was just a warm-up.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Is it on? Yes? Okay, great. So this is a BDAA Festival Orchestra. You can see everybody here from different cities. an event from Russia, guests from Russia. Our first piece was composed by Vasily Andreev, the founder of the Russian Folk Orchestra. The idea was to put together the orchestra of folk instruments for the Russian Tsar, and it was a very patriotic and nationalistic idea. And just like the symphony orchestra, this orchestra has all sizes, starting with prima dombras, little ones, going on to secundas, a little bit bigger, and altos, tenor, and basses, the big ones, the cello of the orchestra. And these are contrabass balalaikas. Requires real manpower to play those. So these are first violins, and then these are second violins. They're also important. So balalaikas, see, these are primas. And balalaikas have three strings, E, and A. Three strings. Well, beautiful. Okay, and they're bigger ones too. Yeah, bigger balalaikas, look. Okay, great. Now we also have wind instruments, flute, oboe, clarinet, and Russian accordion or bayan. There, button accordion. Yeah, and of course, percussion. So Vasily Andreev was the founder of this type of the orchestra, and he composed a lot. And Gusli, yes, of course. Gusli is Russian harp. It's Russian harp. This is an instrument similar to what Homer accompanied himself, probably, you know, in ancient tradition. So Polonez is, of course, is a Polish dance, but it was immensely popular in Russia. Mikhail Glinka composed Polonezes, and always when the Tsar received, the Emperor of Russia received people, they always started the balls, and they had lots of grand balls with Polonezes. So you just heard the Polonez. Our next piece composed by Yevgeny Derbenko, one of the most prominent accordion players in Russia and the composers of the Russian Folk Orchestra. He was also the leader of a very popular ensemble, Arlovsky Souvenir, for many years. And I believe he's still living. So, Lyrical Mood. Thank you. Our next number is by Georgi Sviridov, one of the most important composers of the 20th century in Russia. He composed a lot of songs and romances and instrumental music. This particular number comes from the music to the play by Alexander Pushkin, The Snowstorm. Thank you. So a lot of the music arranged is based on Russian folk songs. Now, this is not a folk song, this was original music, but the composers, great arrangers, they use the folk material, beautiful Russian folk heritage for inspiration. So next piece is I'm Blamed by the People, or Vinyat Minya v Narodi in Russian, is composed by Alexander Shalov. We will need a chair here. And our soloist is a very well-known balalaika performer, Yuri Shishkin. You already heard him in the first half. Yuri Shishkin performed in St. Petersburg, Moscow, many republics of the former Soviet Union, in Turkey, also in the United States, yeah, all over the world.
Thank you.
next piece is called Chastushki with garmoshka. Chastushki is a little ditty, is a funny, often comedic kind of a poem, a folk song. It's very simple, usually motif that everybody remembers. You can hear still people making those up in Russian countryside. And the composer, the arranger of this number, Alexander Tsigankov, is probably the most decorated domra player in Russia right now. He's a great musician. He plays a three-string domra, and he made a wonderful arrangement. And garmoshka is, of course, is a little accordion. Difficult virtuosic accordion part. Anatoly Mamalyka. We're very fortunate to have wonderful musicians. You heard Anatoly and Irina play in a duet, and Irina will be doing a solo piece. You know, there are great musicians with a really great Russian, Ukrainian heritage, and worked during the Soviet era, I believe, yeah? During the Soviet era, so-called era of stagnation, but it was very rich era culturally, when many music ensembles and great soloists performed, and Russian art was on a very, very high level. Very high level. So one of the pieces we will do right now, it's composed by Dmitri Shostakovich, probably the greatest Soviet composer, or one of a few greatest composers of the 20th century. And this comes from the play, actually from the book, and then the movie called The Gadfly. And the movie is based on a story of the Garibaldi resistance during the Italian War for Independence. Of course, you probably have heard Verdi's operas, and so this concerns that that era. The book was composed in 1897. It was immensely popular in Russia, particularly by revolutionaries, of course. As you can understand, there was a movie made, and the writer Ethel Voynich made several trips to Russia. I don't know if she wrote anything else, but she was actually also a very prolific composer, by the way, but not very, very well known. So only this book exists. So now this is probably the most famous tune from this movie. And by the way, Dmitri Shostakovich was a very prolific composer of movie music. Starting from 1929 and on, he composed a number of great scores. Thank you. Next piece is music by Evgeny Derbenko once more, arranged by Anatoly Mamalyga and Irina Arlova. A wonderful piece called Karnaval. You will hear a lot of Latin American rhythms there. Very exciting. Percussion player just joined us today. Russian Folk Orchestra plays arrangements of classical music, as you already know, not only folk music. And here's a very good arrangement by Viktor Gorodinsky, who is a very active member of BDAA and directs the orchestra in Madison, Wisconsin. Unfortunately, he wasn't able to be here, but this is his arrangement of the scene from the Swan Lake by Peter Lee Tchaikovsky, composed in 1877.
Thank you.
great piece of music. If you have not had the chance to hear the whole thing, I highly recommend it. All right, our orchestra plays international selection of music, and the next one, once again arranged by Anatoly and Irina, is an Israeli folk song, Hava, nagila, which means we're to rejoice with us. And this was composed in the beginning of the 20th century when Jews started to immigrate to Palestine and making it their home. And so it's one of the most popular Jewish songs. Irina Arlova in Chardash by Vittorio Monti, a wonderful piece of music, Hungarian Romanian dance. Hungarian. Actually, that this piece originally was composed for mandolin and orchestra, and then for violin and mandolin. Yeah. And of course, the Hungarian orchestra would include many similar instruments. Yeah.
Thank you.
I hope you enjoyed tonight's program. Thank you. Thank you very much. Now, our last final number is Vesyolaya Kadril. It's actually a quadrille, a square dance for couples.
Russian version.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. But wait. There's something else going on.